When Crowded House played their farewell concert on the steps of the Sydney Opera House 25 years ago, tears were shed all over the world, but especially in New Zealand and Australia. The music, made by Neil Finn, Nick Seymour and Paul Hester, was so loved that knowing it was over was tough to take. But for Crowded House fans, the pain is about to end. The band is reforming, although renovating might be a better way of explaining it, because there are some new members joining the lineup. One thing's for certain though, that legendary Crowded House sound will be as memorable as ever.
Stunning part of the world.
It's a gorgeous place. A lot of songs written out here.
Not hard to find inspiration, I wouldn't have thought.
No. It's definitely imbued in my bones and my soul, this place. Walking round the room
singing stormy weather. Crowded House is famously a trans-Tasman band, but for its iconic New Zealand frontman, Neil Finn, Australia has never felt further away than this last year.
I'm trying to get my bearings here. So we're facing...
Sydney.
Straight across the ditch.
Yeah. Well, probably halfway between Sydney and Melbourne if you want to really
split
draw a particular line.
Like the rest of us, COVID has meant more time at home than ever before for Neil on the blustery stretch of coast to the west of Auckland. You let your tears rain down on me. But while the world was working from home, Neil was working on getting his iconic band back together. And nothing says COVID-era project quite like people dialing in on Zoom.
Feels a bit like we've got the United Nations of Crowded House here. We've got America joining us, and Australia and Ireland, and the New Zealand contingent keeping the home fires burning.
Yes, we have. It's not the first time we've done that in the last 12 months. It's been the story of the last 12 months, except for a little golden month that we had all together in the same room.
Is there any unexpected upside to putting an album together like this?
It should be noted that Nick attended a mix session on Zoom in a full-body wetsuit, having just got out of the surf, in the front seat of his car.
Crowded House has had a renovation of sorts from when it was first built back in 1986. While the ever-present foundations of Neil Finn and Nick Seymour remain, they've added the group's longtime producer, Mitchell Froome, on keyboard, and also Neil's two sons, Liam and Elroy. The chemistry was instant.
And that's why I wanted to join the band, was after I got to play in a room with Neil and Liam and Elroy and Nick, it just felt right away like it had something about it where you could bring in different people, but no one could play this music better.
There's a lot of pride in me and Elroy being able to be part of this with Dad. And I sort of dreamed that I'd get to do that one day with them, you know, and in some ways that's sort of been realised in its own way.
And then other times when you actually try and be that relaxed, it's quite hard.
Well, if it's too hard for you, Dad, I'm happy to do it for you.
And I've watched Liam become an amazing songwriter and performer, watched Elroy become a great arranger and songwriter, and it's just such an asset to have that in the band, you know.
I feel the proud dad really coming through.
There's all manner of different feelings attached to it, but bands need to have some soul and some spirit, and I don't think there's five people on the planet who feel, live and breathe the Crowded House ethos more than this five, so yeah, it feels natural, actually.
Liam was just two when Crowded House was formed, and Elroy only a glimmer in Neil's eye. Much of their early life was spent on the road with the band. Teeming with humour, sadness and wisdom, Crowded House's songs have become an intrinsic part of our collective DNA. But in 1996, after a decade together, Neil decided to call time on the group. They said an emotional goodbye at the now iconic Farewell to the World concert on the Sydney Opera House forecourt. Some estimates put the crowd on that November night at 250,000 people. To sort of get myself in the zone last night, I watched the Opera House show on YouTube. Even this grainy old copy, I still got chills up my spine.
Yeah, good.
And that's just me watching this old copy. I just can't begin to imagine the rush for someone like you up there soaking all of that in.
It was kind of a profound experience because I don't think there's ever been and ever will be as many people on the forecourt at the Sydney Opera House. It felt so sort of special that I had to keep taking mental snapshots. Yeah, you just want to make sure you give your best. It's going to be a defining moment.
Nick, do you remember how you felt that night?
It was a perverse mixture of pride and irony, you know, because we were breaking up and I didn't want the band to break up. But the energy of that night is quite extraordinary.
The band members went their separate ways, but were united in grief in 2005 when drummer Paul Hester took his own life. Somewhere deep inside, something's gotta hold on you. Heartbroken, Neil paid tribute to his dear friend at that year's ARIA Awards with a solo performance of a Crowded House anthem. And I know I'd ride for the first time in my life. That's why I tell you, you better be home soon. It inspired the group to reform, but that was short-lived. Three years ago, though, Neil rediscovered his love of being in a band when he joined Fleetwood Mac on its world tour.
I went and saw Fleetwood Mac when you were playing with them, and afterwards, my wife and I actually said to each other, Neil Finn looks like he's having so much fun up there.
I was, yeah. I mean, it was a delicious opportunity to be something, part of something I would never have guessed that I would get that. It was, and they're a great band. I got, you know, John McVie and, you know, Mick Fleetwood playing drums and bass, singing with Stevie and Christine every night. You know, what fun that is, what joy that is.
The fuse was lit. Just before the world was plunged into lockdown, Neil hit the phones and breathed new life into Crowded House.
It's an instinct or an intuition, I guess, that this was a really good time. And I think inadvertently we chose the perfect time to become a band as the world was plunged into such a strange time, because we had each other to share the music with, to make a record with, collaboration, companionship, camaraderie, all of the above. And we now know that we're a really hot live band as well, so.
After recording several new songs, Crowded House has returned to the stage in New Zealand to an adoring home crowd.
Does that give you that extra sense of, you know, the magic and really appreciating the joy of it all because it was taken away for a while?
Yeah, it did, and just the rareness, the rare pleasure of it for everybody. You can see everyone's faces out in the audience. So they had that kind of little bit of a glazed look in their eyes, like, my God, here we are, this is actually happening, you know. Something so
strong. And next up, it's Australia's turn at the end of this year.
So when you tour Australia, do you lean into perhaps calling yourself an Australian band?
I feel enormously flattered and kind of privileged that Australians consider the band an Australian band, and they consider me a kind of honorary Australian in that context. And I wouldn't buy into one or the other. Yeah, it's just like being adopted by a second family, you know. Got to feel lucky.
It's hard to actually say that we're an Aussie band or a New Zealand band.
Look, we're a Norfolk Island band, okay?
Happy halfway.
There is freedom within,
Given his five decades of songwriting success, Neil Finn has been dubbed by some as the Antipodean Paul McCartney. He's created so many melodies that you just can't help but sing along to. It's a musical legacy that spans generations, not just with his fans, but now with his family as well.
These songs have travelled and become part of people's relationship with their parents and their kids. You know, that's the thing that feels really exciting when we play these shows, is that there's sometimes three generations of people in the audience.
It's pretty special that you bridge generations. Like, I love that idea that you were talking about, that, you know, the three generations come. Like, to bring, I mean, it's brought your family together.
Yeah.
But it also brings other families together, and it's pretty special.
Yeah. And music is pretty special, you know, like, as time goes on, as if we didn't already know. And in these times, in this age, music is probably the most positive thing I can think of as an influence in the world. It feels very, very special.
Hello, I'm Tom Steinfort. Thanks for watching 60 Minutes Australia. Subscribe to our channel now for brand new stories and exclusive clips every week. And don't miss out on our Extra Minutes segments and full episodes of 60 Minutes on 9now.com.au, as well as the 9Now app.